We're going through all the features and functions of the Bernina 570. We have over 100 video tutorials that you can watch for free on YouTube. So make sure you check out our complete playlist and explore this machine from corner to corner. And if you want to learn more, check out our Embroidery Essentials online course. We've got links in the description below. But I wanted to go ahead and talk about virtual positioning. If you really want to master your machine, I invite you to our Embroidery Essentials online course. Those are some of the quilts back behind here, where we complete over 15 embroidery techniques, mastering every corner of your embroidery machine so you can flawlessly use it for everything that your heart wants to create. So in this video, we're going to help you master virtual positioning. So that is actually a term that is fancy for being able to know where your design is going to stitch on the fabric. Or if you are doing something that is allowing you to hoop or stitch something out and then have to re-hoop to connect the next one and the next one, that is going to be your best friend. If you're doing edge-to-edge quilting and you have one design stitched and you need to hook the other one up to it, how do you get these two stitches to start and stop identical after you've taken the fabric out of the hoop? So I have a design on screen that's a little bit more of a long, skinny design. So first off, I need you to go to the hoop setting and activate the last function on this row. So at the top where we have the park options, the grid, and then also I have both of them on right now. So let me just turn them off. This is design positioning. This is virtual positioning. Now that's a fancy word for being able to see where you are within the hoop. So right now, if I just move this design around, nothing changes. The hoop doesn't move. The design just goes wherever you think it needs to be. But if you had a mark on your fabric that you needed to be on when you start, and that's the center of your design, this is how we're going to do it. Touch the hoop feature, come all the way down to the last two functions, turn on virtual positioning. Next, if we come out of here, this will allow us to move that design, and you're noticing that your hoop moves while you do that. Now, right now, if I touch it, it is moving this little kind of crosshair into different positions, and that would be me wanting to see where that stitch is. Before we get fancy like that, let's go to the oval and activate the function right above it for the center. It locks the center stitch on our screen, and this would be great because if you did have a drawn location for your center of your design, you're going to activate both of those, and now when you move this around, it's moving the needle to that location. You can get it just right. You can use your knobs to fine-tune it up, down. Tip your needle down into the fabric with your hand wheel. See if you're right on your mark, and then you'll know that you can start embroidering and it will stitch in the correct position. So let's say we've stitched this design out, and you can see it looks like we could probably re-hoop it and stitch another one and then another one and connect it all together. So let's say we have one of these designs already on the hoop. Now for connectivity, we need to pick a stitch that is more, say, up in the top corner of this. Let's zoom in on that area here. We're going to zoom, and we can actually find where that actual stitch is, and we can find that exact point. And then when we come out of here, I'm going to unzoom us, then we can move this to connect to where the last stitch actually was. And we know that because what stitch we've picked here, that's going to move the needle. And then when those two connect on fabric and you start, then you will have no gap between where the last one was and where the new one starts. And it's pretty awesome to get everything located and be able to re-hoop something and start again and make a design even bigger. So virtual positioning, I will tell you, takes a little bit of practice exploring and trying it out. So hopefully the next time you try it, you can do it when you don't need it, and you can experiment on your own. And then again, when you do need it, it will be waiting for you, ready to use.